Hi friends, welcome to Srinu Technologies. Myself Ram Kumar. Today we will discuss more about this error management. So in our previous video we have seen in what scenario we have to do some exception handling and what are the such use case we have seen a sample, we have seen division by zero, and then we have seen how to handle it, how to and how to resume it, right? So that's we have seen in our previous video. So now we will see there is a use case where we need to throw an exception explicitly. Means if you see here, the division by zero happened on its own and then there is a problem in the calculation stage and then we have seen an error, right? So then which we have handled. Now what I'm saying is, think that there are two processes, sub process, which we will be calling based upon one or two, case one or two. Or if there is a happy path, means if every details are there, means you need to process based on two input values, which are values which you are reading from some third party or you are getting as an input, right? If the input is you are getting, the process will be executed very fine and then it's a happy path. So what if the values are, so you are doing a check whether the values are proper or not. So in that, while doing the validation, you came to know that there is a problem and then you cannot continue the process because the values which you are expecting to come in, they did not come. Means the person who have called the process or the values from where we have to get, we have not got the values. There is no point in continuing that process, that flow, right? So what will happen is, we cannot stop the process like that as it is in the middle, right? So what we can do is, we will do something called throwing an exception, right? We will use one more stage here where we can throw an exception, right? You will see how we can use a exception stage. So we have seen recover and resume stage, where once exception happens, what we can do is same we have seen in recover and resume stage. But we will see how to throw an exception explicitly, because when the values, input values are zero, we have not started the process. So the process will not throw an exception, but you want to throw an exception so that you want to stop that particular process and then move on to some other sub process which has processing logic when the inputs are not available. Okay, process one or sub process one or page one is having a logic based on the input fields. Means if the input fields are valid, go with this process page one. If the input values are not valid, go with sub process page 2. So that is how we can do it here. So there is a provision for us to throw an exception and then means we can divert the process accordingly, right? So for that, what you have to do is, we have to use something called exception stage. And then when you are seeing exception stage, in the recover and resume earlier, we have seen division by zero is what is the exception detail, right? Or exception type. So now here, as we are throwing the exception, system is not throwing the exception, so we have to explicitly say what is the type and what is the detail. Means whatever we'll be writing as the type and the detail will be shown in the recovery and resume stage. That we will see it now. Okay, let's go to the tool now and see how we can throw an exception. So we are here, right? So what we have seen is, once validation is happening, we are seeing that recover logic is working fine for us. So what I will do is, I will remove this, and then this I will do, and then something. So this is like this. But if think that there is a decision which we are keeping, like we are doing some validation whether the values are proper or not. Okay, check y. This is a decision I am checking. So e is y. So I am checking whether y is greater than 0 or not. What will happen? This will avoid division by 0 exception. Alright? So if what I am saying is y greater than 0? X can be 0. The result will be 0. But if y is 0, we will have a error here. Right? What I am doing is, I am checking whether the y is zero, greater than 0 or not. Greater than 0 means it should start from 1 or not something. Right? See, if it is greater than 0, what you can do? So it will start will come here, it will do the verification whether y is 0 or not. If it is yes, means the y is greater than 0, go to the division, set the success and then move forward. No, if the value is no, what we can do is, if you see here on the left, we have something called exception, right? There is something called exception. So if you see here, the important thing you have to understand is, for record there is no input, but for exception there is no output. Think logically why it is like that. So exception is thrown means, when an exception is thrown, it can be caught by the requires which are created in this process or object, right? So it will be in air, means there can be one or more recovery logics which we can keep. I can keep one more recovery stage, nothing will stop me. If you see here, this is recovery 2 which I am doing, right? I will make an link. Okay, let me use some anchor. Right, if you see here what I am doing, so I am having two recovery modes here. So set failure message here is something different. So I will say reset value is not 5, I will keep 10, so that we will understand. So failure, so we will keep just only failure, initial stuff, simple message, exception, execution failed, something like this. So we have, so two different values, which is reset y as 5 and reset y as 10. So these are the two values we are having. If you see here, so whichever is created first, if the, so this is a simple rule where if an exception is thrown from here, just think that exception is throwing some signal out of the program, and then this can be caught by recover 1 or recover this thing. Okay, I will use the name as recovery 2 to remove confusion. Okay, this is resume 2, as we have copy pasted same name scheme, right? So what we are thinking is, recovery 1 or recovery 2 will be caught, and then the respective process will be done. Okay, so exception will not have output, record will not have input, it is based on the signals which are sent out of the exception, then we are caught. So one important thing what is we have seen is, in the theory we have to set the exception in the detail, that you should not forget here. And then what you have to do is, you have to double click here, and then if you see here, this is an exception. So what is an exception type? So in normal world, the exception types are business exception, application exception, system exception, many things. Means you have done some verification, and then during validation you came to know that there is a means you cannot proceed with the next steps as the validation got failed. Example, you want to enter the student name in a registration form. If there is no student name, means it's a validation fail, you cannot proceed with the registration, right? It's a business exception. So I'm giving the name as business exception. And what is the detail? So what I'm saying is, I know what decision I have made. So here the decision I have made is, y is less than 1, or y is equal to 0, or y is not greater than 0. So y is not greater than 0, likely to get error, please reset. This is the message which we are giving. So it's a string, so we need to give in this thing. This is how we have to give, right? So let's, okay, so we have set the detail and type. So let's see whether the set failure will capture that as part of that message or not, right? We have kept type and detail, so we have kept both. But in the message, we have seen only which stage, detail, and we did not get type. So let us see the type also. I will add one more thing. Exception is exception detail and ampersand, I will say it is type. Okay, I will say type is, and I will use exception type. If you see here, okay, I will use that here. Type is exception type, and is the validation correct? Expression is valid. So what I'm saying is, execution failed, error is exception detail, type is exception type which we have created, and then this is what I'm expecting in what, from which stage. This is the what I'm expecting in the resume between the failure message which we will be getting, right? Let's quickly run this and see what is happening here. Right. So check why. Y is 0. It is throwing an exception which will be caught by recovery 1. Set the failure message. Reset the value as 5 and do the valuation. Yes. Right. If you have seen here, this is what is happened. Right. We did not go back to the division, but something happened like this. If you see here, if I go back to the message and show you execution failed, error is Y is not greater than 0, like to get error, please reset. This is the exactly the detail which we have kept in. So this is the error which is caught, and this is type is business exception, the type which we have set actually. Stage is exception stage. If you see here, stage is not calculation stage or division stage. Earlier message we have seen the exception is because of division stage, but here the stage is shown as exception because we are throwing an exception from the exception stage, so it is giving the name as exception stage. It's not giving the name as division stage or calculation stage. Means for which stage we have got is exception stage. We can give some numbers also, we will, so that if you are having multiple exceptions in your program, give the numbers so that here when you see the number you will understand, okay, I have got error from exception 3, which is okay in my program. Exception 3 is at a particular location, so this got failed, this decision got failed. So you can pinpoint the exception, then you can move forward. So throwing exceptions is of very much use when we are dealing with business exceptions, right? This is much better application or system also. Can, for example, you are trying to read some element and then you are not getting it, then you will take a decision, you will do a checkbox where is the input value came or not. Yesterday we are trying to read some temperature from weather report, right? Think that you got some, you did not get any value from it. So then we will do a validation, say that error in getting the temperature, and then you cannot proceed, and then you will throw this exception and then you will set some default value, something like this. So you have to understand the concept here, and then this is something called as throwing an exception, right? Let's get back to the slide once and then just continue with the next topic. So next we have something called exception bubbling. So exception bubbling is nothing but we have seen in our business object that we have created an exception, and then we have recur and resume mode is there. So when the recur and resume mode is there, we are suppressing the exception or we are providing a solution for the exception. So there is no problem for the process. But if it is not caught, if you see the diagram in the below, the business object we have at page C, means in some action in business object, there is an exception occurred and we don't have recur or resume logic kept there. So it comes to process page 2, and then it comes to process page 1, and it comes to the main page. So this kind of moving the exception to the higher level or to the calling stage or the calling page is called exception bubbling, simple, right? So you understand, main page is calling page 1, page 1 is calling page 2, page 2 is calling page C of business object. So that is the hierarchy, right? But what happened is there is some exception occurred here and there is no recovery and resume logic kept there. So what happened is the exception bubbled up to the main page. This is called exception bubbling. If you don't have resume and recovery, recovery and resume stages in the main page also, what will happen? The process will terminate and then you will see a pop-up which you have seen earlier. But if you have a recovery and resume stage, you will not see any pop-up. We can have the complete logging details of the exception, so which we can see it, right? So that is how we have to we can see what is happening. So we can quickly check this. Okay, before that we will have one more thing, so which is exception blocks. So these blocks, so we have seen earlier, for a calculation stage or for a if you are throwing an exception for a calculation stage, for a division stage, anything, all for all it is thrown inside an air, means into space, and then whichever recovery is close to it is catching it, and then we are going through the recovery and resume process. But what we want is, for calculation stage, we want a particular recovery stage. For a division, we want a separate recovery stage. For the decision box, for the business object which we are throwing, we want a separate recovery stage. In that case, what we will do is, we have to use this so-called exception block. So that exception block is nothing but, instead of make it generic, we are saying that for this stage, this is the recovery. So we are doing a mapping actually. Okay, let us quickly see this exception blocks, how it works, and then exception bubbling we will use from, we will call our process, we will call our object from process, and then we will see the exception bubbling, right? Let's go back to the tool now. Right, so here if you see here, so what I'm saying is, if you see here, think that division is something happening, and then there is an exception thrown here, here also at division. So if an exception thrown from division, or the exception we throw it explicitly, what all are going through recovery one only, because it is taken care in that way. Okay, what I will do is, I want whatever exceptions I throw from this exception stage should be caught by only recovery 2. Recovery 1 should not come into picture. So then what I will do is, I will create something called a block. Okay, so what I will do is, if you see here, below the link we have something called blocks. It's not a stage, it's a block. So what I'm saying is, I will draw a grid. See here, earlier we have seen, when there is an exception occur, it is going for recovery 1. But what we are doing now is, what I am doing now is, I am mapping that for this division, only recovery 1 should respond, recovery 2 should not respond. And for this exception, only recovery 2 should respond. So I am setting a mapping, right? So this is called as exception block. So simple. Right, don't get confused. It's just that what we are doing is, using exception blocks, we are mapping for this particular exception stage, or for this division stage. You think that, okay, there is a possibility of getting an error, right? You know that there is a possibility of getting error. So what you are doing is, you are just saying that for this possibility of getting an error, for this division stage, always go to recovery 1 only. Don't go to recovery 2. But for exceptions which we are throwing explicitly, I am saying go to recovery 2 only, don't go to recovery 1. So what is the failure? We have kept exception stage, and then we are not seeing any message here. We just said execution failed. Reset the Y to 10, and then what we are saying is, and then do a resume. Or once, as we are saying resume, instead of connecting to end, what I will do is, I will connect it to division stage also. I can do that. See here how we can use. So I can change the program as I want. So the thing is, if the Y is 0, set the value to 2 and then do the division and then proceed. That's what I'm saying here, right? So let us quickly run this. So let me save first. If we don't save, it will not be getting affected. So check Y. Y is 0, go to exception and go to recovery 2, and then set the failure message, set the Y as 10, resume means go to division, it is going to division through the anchors, redo the result and then set the success message. If you see here, this is what has happened clearly. So this is exception block, clear? So what we will do is, first time being, I will remove this, I will not have this recovery stage here. I think this is what is called as exception block, and we have seen exception, how to throw and everything. So we will see exception bubbling quickly. So for that, we will call this from, so I will have a new action which I will be calling exception bubbling sample. Okay, I have a new thing, where I will copy only relevant, means I will do this only. Okay, I will do a copy paste so start commit twice. So this is what is having. So if you see here, I will remove this. So if you see here, the exception is thrown but is not caught, right? There is no recovery and resume stage in my business object. You have to understand this, right? I will call this also, and I will call, so I am publishing these two actions. This is action 1 and this is action 2, right? This is action 1 and this is action 2. So in this, if you see here, the exception is done, and then we can see the result. I will just say what is the result I am sending, right? Or what we'll do, we will send the message. That would be better, I think, because we want to see the message, right? So you say text here, text, and then I want to see the message, and then I will say message, okay, or status is the message. So this is what I want to return from here, and then same I will do with this thing also. Okay, we need to have the variables. We did not have the variables, so we have to copy paste the variables also here, right? So and I will map the same thing. I will say is status, right? This is what is happening. So these are very fine for us, right? So what is the error? Set failure, stage is not partially within a block. Set failure, where is set failure? Is there a set failure? Okay, no issues. I think just this will work. Okay, no issues. So saving, let me call these two actions which I have published from process, right? So we know that, so this is our, and then I will create a new process for exception handling. Okay, process. Okay, exception handling sample. So what I will do is, I will call the business object from here. So how you will call a business object? Using the action stage. So what is the exception handling sample? So exception bubbling and sample exception. Sample exception has an output, if you see here, just status, and then we will run this. So I'll keep action 1 only for now, and then we will see what is the status message we are getting. So we have caught the exceptions there, right? So let's see whether this just will be getting a stage, or we will getting a success or any error. So when I run this, if you see here, I'm just getting successfully executed, means there is a successful executed, and then we have got the result also, there is no problem. But if I call the next one now, means I will call, so here we are throwing an exception, so we are not catching it, means when we are calling the action 2, which is exception bubbling sample, what is happening is an exception is being thrown in the business object, and then we are not catching it, so it bubbled up to the process. So this is called exception bubbling, right? So if we don't catch it here, what will happen? The process will terminate. If I catch it, it will come to the recovery stage here. So if you see this, we have got an error. What is that error? Y is not greater than 0, likely to get error, please reset. This is the same message we have kept, but it is a, when we are getting a pop-up, means it is being, the process getting terminated. If you see here, it will not run. But if I catch a recover and resume stage here, now we will not get any pop-up, but instead the process will continue and then come to the end. So we are handling the exception bubbling in the process, main process stage. So if you see here, it came to recovery, resume, and end. We can have a similar reset or message, status message, everything here. Means what I will do is, if you see here, I will add a calculation stage here, right? I will add a calculation stage here, and then what I will do is that exception which you got, the detail, right? I am setting it to the status. You got me? So what we are doing is set error detail. So we are setting that to the status, right? And then I will use this in between recover and resume. So this is what you have to do it. So simple. If you see here earlier, it went and then we have got a pop-up and we did not get the status message also. Now if you see, we will be getting a status message as we are rightly handling it. Recover, get the details and set to status and then resume. So if you see here, we have got a status, the same message which we got earlier. Right? This is how we do a handling. So this is exception bubbling and then how we are doing it, dealing it within the main page. Right? So hope you have understood. Keep watching our videos. Keep learning.